In this session, we are going to talk about rigid bodies and moments. We earlier discussed about forces. We used the equation sum of all the forces equal to zero in solving static equilibrium problems. This approach worked very well for particle equilibrium problems. As you recall, a particle is a concentrated mass. Shape and size of an object is ignored when we consider that object as a particle. Particle is typically represented as a dot, so there is no rotation. However, this approach won't work when we deal with the analysis of bodies for which we cannot ignore their dimensions. In other words, we can't use the particle assumption all the time. If we want to analyze a body in detail, we have to consider its shape and size. We are going to assume such bodies as rigid bodies. A body that does not change its dimension under the action of forces is a rigid body. Since rigid body has actual dimension, we cannot ignore the rotation. Rotation relates to moment. So let's talk about moment. We use the word moment in our everyday life. We use it often to indicate an interval in time. There is even a great song, one of my favorites, by Whitney Houston. I want one moment in time. However, in the context of engineering, moment is very different. Moment can be considered as a rotational force. Let me explain. We know force is a push or a pull. But force alone is not enough to do our daily work. Think about driving. We have to rotate the steering wheel. Think about pulleys. In all these cases, we have to deal with rotational motion. How do we create rotational motion? It can be done using a force, a push, or a pull. Let me start with an example. Here I have a wrench. A wrench is used for tightening a bolt or loosening a nut. Let me hold the wrench like this. If I want to use it, I have to apply a force somewhere here on the handle. This force is a push applied at a distance from the center of rotation. This push creates what I call the tendency of the force to rotate the body about an axis that passes through the center. So, moment is a tendency of a force to rotate an object about an axis. The magnitude of the moment is equal to force times the perpendicular distance from the line of action of the force to the center of the rotation. Hence, the unit for moment is going to involve the unit for force and distance. Unit for moment is Newton meter in SI system. Unit for moment is pound foot in US customary system. What we are going to do now is learn how to calculate the moment of a force in two-dimensional plane with some examples.